everybody, and welcome back to the Average Woman Podcast. I am that lady, Miss Nicole, coming at you today with another topic that is near dear to my spirit. So let's get into it. Let's talk about it today. But before we begin, I just want to tell you to please go over to my YouTube channel. Make sure you like and subscribe. I'm also on Spotify, the Average Woman Podcast. NicoleArcher.com is my website. 30 minutes, we can talk about anything you want. Schedule an appointment. I am your sister from a different mess. I'm here for you. So, ladies, today we're going to talk about something that's going to be kind of uncomfortable, but it's all good. It's all good. Because I'm coming from love. Well, Miss Nicole, who is you? Nobody. And that's a good thing, because that means I can give you the unfiltered truth. I'm not coming at you trying to get your money. I'm not trying to come at you to get nothing from you. I just want to tell you what worked, so at least you'll know the truth, and once you know the truth, you know, you can do what you want to do with it, you know? But certain things work, and certain things don't work in life, right? And unfortunately, we have to, as women, have to come to realize that we have actually destroyed our community, right? We've destroyed our families, which is our support system, you know? A lot of you women, you always talk about how hard it is to be a single mother. Well, the thing is that, yeah, you didn't get pregnant by yourself, right? Not only did you get pregnant from him, but he got a whole family out there with sisters and brothers and everything. But y'all just act like these people don't exist, so you don't want to be bothered. So we got to stop acting like there's no other option for us doing what we're doing. You know, because you don't accept the truth that it's, that, you know, it's our fault for our conditions, you know, you really not going to ever get ahead. I don't care if you don't believe it, it's true. Women, you are the reason why our economy, our relationships, our marriage, our children, you are the reason why things are the way they are. Because you run the show. The men don't really have no say-so, especially when it comes to the kids. Like, men are kind of like football, you know, in the back. You know, back when Al Bundy was the beginning of the get rid of dad because he's an idiot kind of vibe. Always down in the men, like they don't know nothing, they can't do nothing. But what can you do? Are you going to go out there and fix anything? No, the hell you're not. So how is it that we feel like we don't need no man? You know, the first, second, third thing that you need to understand is that as a woman, you can't do everything. You are not superior, right? You need a man. You need somebody to help you organize your thoughts, someone to help you make your shit make sense. A lot of y'all doing the most, and ain't none of y'all shit making sense, because it's like you don't have nobody to really lead you, and you really don't want to because you know everything. So when 5-10 years go by, and you done painted yourself into this corner, you like, oh my God, how did I get here? You put yourself there. You put yourself there. You put yourself there because you refuse to accept the fact that, like, it's only one truth. And you can't serve two masters. Either you gonna be a good wife or a bad wife. Or, well, either you gonna be a wife or no wife. That's it. You don't really have a choice. See, a lot of people have, you know, society has led us to believe, like, you can do whatever you want, you can be however you want, but men don't like that. See, men don't like women who don't understand that they need to be women. See, you can get a man to have intercourse with you, but it's a whole different ball game when you want a man to marry you. When you want a man to wife you and take you on as his responsibility, it's certain things that he gonna be expecting from you that if you aren't showing in the beginning, he not even entertaining marrying you. Marrying you for what? And a lot of times, the men, you know, y'all make bad choices because y'all marrying people who just totally fake. You know, it's all right for a woman to get dressed up from time to time to do her little thing. But when you constantly living in fake fingernail land, fake hair land, fake eyelash land, every day 365, like that's who you are, and you gonna do that till you 60, we're not living in reality. We're not living in reality right now. And truth be told, any grown woman at this point that's listening to these little young girl rappers, if you over 20 and you listening to these young girl rappers, you need something to be done with you. You need to be examined. Because what kind of vibe, when did the whole vibe become like a good thing? That's not a good thing to be a hoe. Men don't marry hoes. Hoes don't raise good kids. Was you raised good? No, you was probably raised by a hoe. And that's why you think the whole shit that you doing is like some good stuff. It's really not. See, the thing is that as time has went on, what we decided is like, we gonna take some of the good stuff from our mama, and then we gonna add our bullshit to it, and then that's gonna be how we live our life. Some kind of way we gonna try to rationalize it. This shit don't make no sense. Y'all, there's only one way to do things, and that's the right way. Like, if you want to try to be somebody's wife, the first thing that you should not be out here doing is in these streets half-naked living your best life. Living your best life doing what? You done lived your best life all through your 20s, 30s. You done got skeeted out mad times. Boxed up and ran through, rummaged through, and now is I'm going to make the next man wait because, bitch, please. You better hope that he still got something to feel. You know? I told you. Nobody gonna buy that cow when you giving out the milk for free. Nobody. Nobody gonna buy the cow when you giving out the milk for free. Because if the milk is free, it's probably spoiled and it don't taste real good. You know, y'all be doing the most. This whole culture that we got going on, ladies, this is not how we get down. This is not how a woman vibes. And as a woman, I just feel like I gotta say something because it's like, y'all getting out of pocket. You know, and listen, I'm just an average woman. Like, I ain't no corporate executive. I'm just a little old woman with a greenhouse and a man and a dog and, you know, just living my little life. So I ain't got nothing to lose in this thing. But for what I'm seeing, y'all just a mess. And a lot of y'all coming down on Erica Mena, but y'all just as bad as Erica Mena. A lot of y'all just as bad as she is. Y'all like to lie, cheat, and scheme. Y'all want to pump a nigga for what he got, then off and running, like you doing something. You hurting yourself. You hurting yourself. Because you think it feels good now to be able to have all kind of bullshit that don't mean nothing. All kind of cold and food and pumpkin. What that's going to be down the line? Ask the woman that's in the club with you that's a little bit too old to be in the club. Ask her, was she not doing the same thing you was doing? Ask Lil' Kim. Look how Lil' Kim looking. Lil' Kim was doing the same shit y'all doing right now. And look at her ass. The last time you seen her looking like a green leprechaun on TV dancing. That shit was embarrassing, mama. And she used to be a baddie back in the day. And that's you. That's who you gonna be getting all kind of surgeries to kind of hide and hide the fat pockets and deposits and shit. Not really doing a good job. And by yourself. Ain't like she got no man holding her down in the later days. One of these hip-hop dudes looking out for her. She got a bunch of young dudes hanging out with her. And that's because when you get the bag, you become a bitch. You the only woman I know that once you get a bag, can't nobody tell you nothing. That you the everything. Just because I get a bag, that don't mean that I run shit. You understand? Because I need to be able to create and do what I need to do, and I want somebody else to take care of the bag, aka my husband. Let him do what he need to do. He gonna set you up to be beautiful. But you gotta follow him. You don't wanna follow nobody. The man be trying to tell you right from wrong. You ain't hearing none of that. You ain't hearing nothing. If you can't get out here and take trips and run up credit card receipts and buy shit that you can't afford just to think that you looking like somebody, you don't know what to do, and I don't even know who the hell you doing it for. Ain't no TV camera following you around. The only people know that you exist is through social media, people seeing your pictures. But you not no star. You not getting paid to do this shit. You're not. Well, some of you. Stop trying to recreate the shit that you see these women doing in the clubs and on TV. Y'all, that's not good. That's not good. The real women are the women that's modest, the women that's soft-spoken, the women who ain't always in the street, gotta be seen and clapping and shit. Those are the women. Those are the ones that's gonna carry us forward. Those are the ones that's gonna have to take care of you when you get old, because you ain't learned right from wrong, you know? Those are the ones that's gonna have their man to themselves in the later days. You know, they say that one woman, gonna be several women cleaving to one man. You know, that's gonna be true. Cause a lot of y'all bum bitches can't do nothing. You can't cook for yourself, you can't take care of yourself. So if he get about five of y'all in the house might function kinda good. That's why they want another one. Because all of y'all, so many incomplete packages. One too emotional, one over here, one over there. So if he get about five of y'all in the house together, perfect package. That's the solution for Blueface, that girl, Stewie Little, Chris Rock girl. You know what I'm talking about. Them three need to buy a house together and live together. Because if you stood by and watch your baby daddy go and mack on this girl all on TV doing the most and this and that, and you just stood by and just chilled, and you know, and he was willing, and you know, all that stuff, y'all might as well go ahead and make it one big family. Because it's already a big old pot of mess. That's how a lot of y'all is. Stop fighting with your boy, your man, baby mama, because he done had kids with ops and all y'all fucking. All y'all screw is all in this all fuck shit. That's why we ain't got nothing. The reason why we ain't got nothing, because y'all, you have to have a family, right? In a family, everybody playing a position. Once we get the house in order, then we can go outside the house and start building with others, right? But you can't come to my house without no man and out of order and disrespecting my house or being making me feel some type of way in front of my husband, being disrespected. So you got to have order. We need a husband, a mama, and kids, right? Be happy. Father leading the house, mama supporting the husband. Mama teaching the kids good things. You got shit to do. You supposed to be raising all these babies, right? You supposed to be raising the babies, providing the babies a home. Shout out to Sukiana. At least she trying. You know what I'm saying? She is out there. But she do cooking, you know, try to take care of her family and be a good mama. I mean, that's a start. Some of y'all ain't even right there. I digress. Anyway, this is what I'm telling you. You gotta have order. We need to come together as humans, then be able to come together and build. You know, that's why a lot of Caucasian women, they marry when they get out of college. Everybody engaged. Everybody about to get married. Because they ready, they got their foundation. They got their income coming in. They got their man. Now they ready to have their babies. And then they get their house. And then they build and reach out to their community. How come we can't do that? You know why? Because y'all just on some fuck shit. Everybody ain't nobody happy with what they got. Ain't nobody happy with what they got. Everybody looking and being envious of the next person and want to sleep with this person, that person. Listen, okay? If you don't want the man, leave him, right? I'm not saying that you go find somebody else. But find the man that you really want to give yourself to and love. That's you. You need to be committed to somebody. That's how you be. You trying to focus on all kind of shit? Focus on just loving one man. The man that loves you and the man that choose you and come and really be like, I want to fuck with you. That's the nigga that you pull in and be like, I love you. And you stop all your whole shit. You come out the clubs. You stop fucking with all them single friends who don't mean you no good. Because I'm telling you, as soon as they get a man, they're cutting you the fuck off. You the one who gonna still be 30, 40. It is not a good look for a 30-year-old woman to still be at the club. If you over 25 still at the club, what's wrong with you? You should be able to find somebody. But you're not gonna find nobody at the club. Because there ain't no love at the club. All it is sex. That's it. Just some sex. And some drugs. And a fight. And that's what it's always been. But it's nice when you can go out like couples and enjoy some music and, you know, have it look. You know, that's what it was for. Not the Friday night, whole night. You know what I'm saying? It's y'all just done turned everything into just a freak fuck show. Like, everything is about, sex. Ain't no business. If they ain't promoting some kind of old fuck shit, y'all ain't even with it. I seen so many people. I ain't never seen so many black people at Juve in my whole life. I didn't even know that many people existed in one part of the country. Y'all come out in a million. Look like million people's out there. But you marching, coming together with your brothers, spending some money with your brothers, supporting your brothers, doing any damn thing, you would think it ain't number five niggas in the world.
About 5 or 10 niggas on the internet. Because you don't give a damn.
You don't give a damn about nothing but turning up and getting your rocks off. You don't care about nothing. How we gonna build something with people who don't give a damn about nothing? I'm trying to attract the people who give a damn. So if you give a damn, hit me up at creamfromcreation@gmail.com or creamfromcreation@nicolearcher.com. Either one. The Gmail is quicker right to my phone, so I get quicker. Hit me up. You know? Hit me up. You about that real life? You trying to connect with people to build something better for you? Baby, I like to talk to people like that. That build up my spirits. You know what I'm saying? Because I'm a positive person, and I mean you well. I want to see you win. Like, I want to see you win. But I'm going to tell you to stop all your bullshit and listen to what I'm telling you. Because I want to see you win. I'm going to give you all that good shit so you ain't got to deal with the bullshit. You ain't got to worry about, you know, everybody, oh, you don't know. You ain't got to fall in the potholes that your mama and your grandmama, your great, because see, Big Mama tried to stop your mama. Big Mama tried to stop your mama and your great and your grandmama from being who they was. But guess what they did? They didn't want to hear that. It was free slaves off that plantation. It was sex, drugs, and rock and roll. It wasn't hearing none of that. None of that. And they carried that. And it's gotten worse. It used to be kind of turned out. Now it's all the way turned out. Y'all done, they done let y'all believe. Y'all done, they done turn y'all all the way out. Over a lie. Because you can't do what you want. Men don't like hoes. And this whole culture that, this whole culture vibe that you got going on, ain't no man gonna like you. God ain't gonna bless you. An average woman, a plain old woman like me, like, you gotta let your works, you gotta do good works by a man to get God to do something for you. You ain't doing good works by no man, God ain't gonna bless you. You gotta do good, you gotta be good to your man. If you want to have longevity success, ain't no woman, think about it, God is a man. God is not going to keep sending you man after man after man the dog out. That's not how he works. You think he's going to keep sending his sons for you to manipulate and dog and drag? That's not how, not, like y'all say, not my Jesus. Not my Jesus. My Jesus wouldn't do that. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, God's not going to keep sending his sons to you for you to destroy their lives and break their spirit and their heart and turn their kids into some kind of monsters. God's not going to do that. He's not going to do that. And you shouldn't expect him to do that, right? What you should do is when you find that one man that he really, really feeling you, he really liking you, he talking that good talk, he interested in being with you, he trying to put a baby in you, he like, you know, if you act right, I could turn you into my wife. That mean that he feeling you. But the problem is that you still think that there's something out there better. No, ain't nothing better than a man that wants to fuck with you. On the real. Ain't nothing better than that. When a man ready to give you his heart on the real, shit, you good. You ain't got a trick or do none of that extra shit. Just be good to him. But we take all that shit for granted, like love is free. Your daddy ain't even damn love you. Your daddy ain't even fuck with you. So when a man come along who not your daddy, who didn't birth you, who finds something positive in your bum ass, how you not going to accept that and be in love with some shit like that? And also, please stop talking about celebrating. What the fuck is we celebrating? What is we celebrating as women? Celebrating breaking our families up? Celebrating being on the bottom in the economy? But the biggest tricks ever because we spending $300 on hair and like $100-something on bullshit. Fuck out of here. What are we celebrating? We should be humble, we should be quiet, and we should be ready to make shit right. Our kids are out of order. You can't even walk down the motherfucking street without somebody trying to shoot you, somebody trying to rob you, somebody all in your business. You kids out of order. And it's because of you. Because you let it get out of hand. Now they asking stupid questions about shit that don't even make no sense and totally irrelevant. They don't even want to believe the truth. They feel like the truth is optional. Like, oh, no, I can make my truth what I want it to be. No, the fuck you can't. The truth is the truth is the goddamn truth. Ain't no changing that. I can't make it up. I want it to be some other kind of truth. But shit is what it is. And when you know the shit is foul and it ain't what you think it is, you have an obligation to change it. Or you can just stay in the shit like most of you do and try to turn that bullshit into some real shit, and that just don't work. You can't turn bullshit into real shit. You can't even entertain stupid shit because it's stupid. Hurt your brain, you know? And it's supposed to make sense. But you do gotta love your man. If you a regular woman, putting on your clothes, regular going to work, working some old bullshit job that you really don't like, but you just do it because you need some money, you know? You got an old piece of man at the house. You know, he might not be the best in the world, but he there with your folky ass. So guess what? Love him. Put all your energy into loving him, making your house better, making your kids feel good. Put your energy into that. Turn off the TV, do some studying, educate yourself on how, whatever shortcomings, whatever you lacking, whatever you feel like you want to work on, if you're trying to get at some money, turn the TV off and start working on you and loving on your family. Loving on your man, bigging up your man, praising your man, making sure he got the things that he need, making sure that he don't want for nothing. Who gonna be taking care of me? Bitch, take care of yourself while you doing this, because that's just obvious, okay? I'm not gonna be taking care of everybody else, and I don't take care of me, but I'm not gonna be concentrated on me, because my focus is my family. Because a woman will be known by her works. And if your works is your family, is your house. And if your shit all out of order didn't fit you, take a drink. If your house out of order, what that say about you? What that say about you? You, God not gonna bless no mess. Remember we used to hear that in the Christian church? I was like, God ain't gonna bless no mess. Well, you right. So guess what you need to do? You need to make sure your house in order. And the first thing that means is that you need to go evaluate what's wrong, listen to what's wrong with your husband. Listen to his complaints and see what you can do to fix it. Listen to your kids. See what your kids' shortcomings is. Find a way to organize your house. Organize your life. Find a way to find things to de-stress yourself. Stop entertaining these people. Cut your friends off. If they're not meaning you no good, they're not bringing nothing good to you, cut them motherfuckers off. You don't need a friend. Your husband is your friend. Focus all your shit on your house. Once you focus on your house, get your house in order, now it's time to get at some money. Because God ain't gonna bless no mess. All this little quick, fast money these girls making, they still not happy. You want to be happy. You want your shit to be longevity. And you don't have no scheme or no none of that. You got to get yours out the mud. Ain't no Illuminati to come and hook you up. Right? You expecting the Most High to bless you. Because you just an average, regular woman like me. Right? Nobody giving us nothing. But God will. Because he's going to bless your works. And when you pray to him, that's what you ask him. Please make my works worthy enough of a blessing so that I can have my heart's desires. So you can get what you want for your family to live good. You know? So you can... So allow yourself to love your husband the way that he is, right? I know he's not perfect. I know you got issues, but you do too. You got issues. Your shit stink. Foul, right? Allow yourself to love your husband the way that he is and put in time to understand who he is and time to listen to him. Work him like you work for that high school, college degree, diploma, or whatever you have. Understand him and listen to him and respect what he been through. Stop making everything about you, because everybody been through some shit, right? But a lot of our shit is self-inflicted, because, you know, we do what we want to do. Men do what they got to do. We do what we want to do. So a lot of your shit is self-inflicted. And once you realize that your shit is self-inflicted, you kind of need to start taking accountability for your own miseries. And you got your kids living bad. You got your husband looking crazy. This man trying to be with you. You won't cook. You won't do nothing. But you want him to treat you like some kind of queen that you're not even worthy of. Right? God not going to bless you. And he probably going to end up taking your man from you. You got to put in work, ma'am. If you you just a regular average woman like me, you gotta put in work, you know, because a woman's gonna be known by her words. But I'm gonna wrap this up. NicoleArcher.com is where I am. QueenFromCreation@gmail.com. Hit me up at any time. I'm your sister from a different mister. I also have some great books on Amazon. Type in Nicole Archer in your Amazon app and my books will pop out. They're spiritual, mental, physical, spiritual, and personal development books. Until next time.